Now, from the CBS 2 Broadcast Center, in the heart of Chicago, this is the news on CBS 2 HD.
Beautiful shot to wake up to. Thousands of people are getting pumped up to run 26.2 miles tomorrow morning. And it doesn't just take a toll on a runner's feet and muscles, but their skin too. And that's why we have Dr. Brooke Jackson here. She's a dermatologist and the founder of the Skin Wellness Center of Chicago. And she's joining us with some ideas to help you protect your skin while you're running in the marathon. So thanks so much for coming in.
Thanks for having me, Suzanne.
So let's get started with something that's really basic. People really don't think about this, and I'm a bad girl in this department. Sometimes when I get so tired with the new baby, you fall asleep with your makeup on. Mm-hmm. But you're saying that's a big no-no, especially when you're getting ready to run.
Especially when you're getting ready to work out. A lot of makeup is very occlusive, and so if you want to avoid acne breakouts, you need to not work out with the makeup. Get it off before. And so we like to use a very gentle cleanser, such as Cetaphil or CeraVe, both of which are available.
We've got some of those right here. Okay.
Yeah, available at the drugstore. Mm-hmm. Just make sure you take your makeup off before you work out.
Okay. And you also say that another really important thing is when you're outside in the elements to think about protection in terms of the gear that you're wearing, a hat.
Absolutely. Because of the higher temperatures tomorrow for the marathon, many runners are going to be wearing fewer layers. You're not going to need to stay warm. And so fewer layers, more sun exposure. Mm-hmm. And so starting from the top, you want to make sure that you wear a hat. Mm-hmm. This will provide sun protection from the top with the visor. This is Cool Max, so it's going to wick the sweat away from you as you sweat.
Okay.
You want to make sure you wear your sunglasses. Mm-hmm. Runners are at higher risk of developing cataracts, and so you want to make sure that you do protect your eyes from the sun. Also, make sure you don't need Botox later on from the wrinkles.
We know where to go for that, then.
Exactly. wearing your sunblock, absolutely key for tomorrow. Make sure that you get it on every sun-exposed area of your body. You want to probably reapply it at about 2 hours, and so there's small containers that you can stick with you in your fanny pack and make sure you get that back on.
You know, too, when you say all areas as well, a lot of people forget their ears.
Absolutely.
Really important part.
Ears in the back of the neck. Make sure you get the back portion of your body as well, the knees, the calves, etc.
It's important to do your scalp as well because you're going to be in the sun for so many hours.
Absolutely. A lot of people develop sunburns, and it's not uncommon to have skin cancer in your scalp as well.
And proper fitting shoes, a big thing.
Big thing. Many people who run a marathon might end up getting purple toes, and so one way to avoid that is to make sure that your shoes are properly fitting. So you want to make sure that they're about a thumb's width wider or longer than your street shoes.
Okay.
And also a square toe box is very helpful.
And you're saying, too, you've got to really avoid friction. People don't really think about that, but what are some good ways to avoid all of the friction when you're running?
Any area that rubs, you want to decrease that coefficient of friction. And so using something like Aquaphor or Vaseline, put it on any area that rubs, such
as on your chest.
Correct.
As well, on your toes.
On your
everywhere.
Toes. If you have a little bit of a bat wing there, you want to make sure that you put that there, inner thighs, too, and especially on your toes, too.
You know what, too, also when you're thinking about just the clothing, you have to make sure that you wash the clothes that you're wearing too if you've got that new driveway fabric. Tell us about that.
Yeah, the rule on marathon day is nothing new for marathon day. You want to have already tried it out. You want to make sure that the clothes are well washed so that they're not rubbing and nothing is coming off on you. So if you bought it yesterday at the expo, make sure you toss it in the wash tonight.
All right. Thank you so much, Dr. Brooke Jackson, founder of the Skin Wellness Center of Chicago. Great advice.
Thank you very much.
And for more information on the link to Dr. Jackson's website, head to CBS2Chicago.com and click on Morning News. And Mary Kay, phenomenal day for running tomorrow.
Yeah, a little warmer than we'd like, but at least it's not going to be the humidity that we had last year. Last year, it felt like we were in Florida running because you had that tropical air mass locked in place. This year, temperature-wise, we will be similar in the mid-60s for the run, but at least we will have drier air in place. Today, 79. Tomorrow, 82. And right on our holiday, Monday, 77. No rain until everyone heads back to work Tuesday.
Fabulous. Nice and comfortable.
We got to watch out for those purple toes, too.
Yeah.
That's right.
I think I figured out why I'm not running the marathon.
Oh, and toenail loss.
Tomorrow at 6 ways to help you spruce up your resume. Then at 10, we're celebrating National Pizza Month with a lesson from Leona's.
And the news continues right here tonight at 10. Take care, everybody. Have a fantastic day.